attempt will be made today to record two underdeveloped countries. I want to talk about South Africa and then talk about Nigeria. They look similar in terms of life expectancy. You can hardly differentiate which one is better than the other. They are just within the same range. And that is why I've classified them as underdeveloped countries. My name is Professor Silvanus Okeke. Today we want to discuss the Global Health Series, number 34. And our discussion will be based mainly on issues that happen in Nigeria and issues that happen in South Africa. Take life expectancy, for instance. Nigeria has a life expectancy of 52 years, and South Africa has a life expectancy of 49 years. You can hardly differentiate between the two. When you compare that with Japan, 84 years, or United States, 79 years, you see a lot of disparity, which means if somebody is born in Nigeria or born in South Africa, almost after 30 years, he would have been dead, whereas the other person is still living. There are issues that militate to these kind of problems, and that's what I'm discussing. The population of Nigeria today is about 177 million, 155,754 persons, while South Africa has a smaller population of 49 million. With that, the largest city in Nigeria is about 9 million people, that is Lagos. South Africa, the largest city, Cape Town, is about 3 million people. So that's a lot of disparity when you compare the two. But the GDP is even very funny. In Nigeria, the GDP is 2,800, whereas the GDP for South Africans is 11,500, which makes it, South Africa looks like a better country than Nigeria in comparison. Whereas somebody will live a little longer in Nigeria than South Africa. So there are things that are happening which government should really look at. The healthcare delivery system, for instance. What is happening in South Africa with all the shanties and people not living well? What is happening with food? People don't have food, a lot of malnutrition. And that is why you have people living within short a lifetime and they are gone. Then the filthiness of the society, the places where they live. All those shanties cause a lot of problems. And then there is this issue of unemployment. The unemployment rates, they are so high in both countries. Nigeria has an unemployment rate of 24%, and South Africa has an unemployment rate of 25%. Both of them are very high when you compare that with what is happening globally. So while other countries are making efforts to ensure that the social determinants of health are improved upon, these two countries are dancing behind because of massive corruption. So what I'm talking about here is the leaders, the policymakers should look at these things and see why are people dying so young in both Nigeria and South Africa when compared to people in Japan or people in Sweden or people in Norway. Why are all those other people living longer? That is where the social determinant comes in. There are issues that determine why people live longer and why people live shorter. And those are issues even the medical system over there should be tackling. Why are some people having insurance and they're able to go to hospitals, whereas others don't? In both countries, there is nothing like universal insurance in those countries, and therefore, people take care of themselves, not the government of the day. These are issues the government should look at and see how they can help the massive poor people to take care of themselves so that they live longer and improve on their life expectancy. And I'm talking of both countries. I'm not just talking of one, because you can hardly differentiate between one from the other. Those are some of the issues the leaders need to touch base on, instead of claiming to be leaders without helping the poor masses. The disparity in treatment between the haves and the have-nots are very conspicuous in those countries, and those are the gaps they ought to bridge so that the poor people will come up a bit and live longer. That's where we are going to stop for today, but we continue discussing this thing so that we see whether the leaders, one way or the other, will be touched to look at issues like the life expectancy, look at issues like the teeming and massive population in the country, look at issues like why should people be bunched up together in Lagos, up to 9 million people. What are all of them doing? Can there be expansion? Can there be creation of jobs for people to go to different areas, different towns and live? And then the unemployment rate, which is so alarming. People go to school and after 10 years, they don't have jobs to do. So what kind of countries are those ones? Those are issues they need to look at. Thank you.